Good morning, everybody. Shall we just have a prayer before we start? Father God, thank you for joining us here together this morning. We hope that the words we speak from Scripture and the songs that we sing will be a blessing to us and will glorify you. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, welcome everybody, and to those joining us online as well. It's good to have you here this morning with the bank holiday. Has anybody got any notices? And also, does anybody have anything they'd like to share that they're celebrating? Because this, we'd like to make this a kind of celebration service. Thank you, Maggie.
Morning. We're going to be having a harvest festival service. It's the third Sunday in September, I believe it's the 19th. Roman will be taking the service. We're going to have a bring and share lunch afterwards. We might serve you your lunches. We're not quite sure how we're going to do that yet. But anyway, it will be a bring and share, and Sandra is going to put out a sign-up sheet for who's going to bring what. So if you could keep that in mind, please, 19th of September. And the other thing is, I haven't got gold medals for everybody, I'm afraid. I underestimated how many people would be here today. But you can see we've got gold medals hanging around our necks. And this is it's a nod to the Olympics, obviously. But it's just to show that God gives us the very best. God wants the very best for us. God loves us so much. And so throughout the service, if we could just keep in mind how much God loves us, as we sing in our songs and pray in our prayers, we are beloved of God. Thank you.
Is there anybody with something to celebrate this morning? Yes, Irene has a birthday tomorrow. Happy birthday for tomorrow, Irene. Mike's birthday today. He probably doesn't want us to say how old he is, but happy birthday, Mike. And also, we'd like to congratulate Mary Beth, who has got her place at Warwick University to study engineering and physics. Right, so just to explain a little bit about the service this morning, when we first thought about the service, we were hoping and anticipating that all the restrictions would have been lifted, that we wouldn't be wearing masks anymore, and that we could just sing. So anyway, what we're going to do is celebrate how far we've come. So we'll sing with our masks. There'll be no announcements between the services, between the sections of the service. It'll be a little bit like we do at the carol service. So people will just come up and do a reading. Feel free to stand or sit as you want to while we're singing, and the service will just carry through until we come to the grace at the end. Okay, so I hope you enjoy what we've put together for you this morning. Thank you. Sorry, I'm doing the first reading. So our first reading is Psalm 100. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations.
Thank you.
Now this reading is from Genesis chapter 1 verses 27 to 28 and chapter 2 verses 2 to 3. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God he created them. Male and female he created them. God blessed them and said to them, "Be fruitful and increase in number. Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the air, and over every living creature that moves on the ground." By the seventh day, God had finished the work he had been doing. So on the seventh day, he rested from all his work. And God blessed the seventh day and made it holy, because on it he rested from all the work of creating that he had been done.
A reading from the book of Zechariah, chapter 13, verses 8 to 9. In the whole land, declares the Lord, two-thirds will be struck down and perish, yet one-third will be left in it. This third I will bring into the fire. I will refine them like silver and test them like gold. They will call on my name, and I will answer them. I will say, "They are my people," and they will say, "The Lord is our God."
Thank you. This reading is from Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 to 18. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armour of God so that you can take a stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armour of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, to stand. Stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints.
We'll have the prayer of intercession. In response to the line, Lord, hear us, please say, Lord, graciously hear us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for keeping us safe in this troubling time and giving us the opportunity to gather here today, despite the situation with COVID-19 in this country. We pray for all those who have been affected by coronavirus, for our life has been completely changed by it. Father, please bring healing to those who have contracted the virus, ease their suffering, and bring comfort to those who have lost loved ones to COVID-19. Father, your peace that passes all understanding, let it be with them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the NHS. Lord, please give them the strength and the drive that they need to continue to treat our nation in this pandemic. We thank you for the doctor, nurses, and carer working so hard in our hospital. We thank you for the blessing of free healthcare and benefits. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for peace and unity in this world. Father, we bring the country of Afghanistan to you. country which is devastated by civil war and so much suffering. Lord, let your love and mercy shine on the people of the country and bring compassion into the heart of the warring factions. Lord, please bestow your wisdom upon all those in position of authority so that they can make the right decision to help men, women, and children of the country. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Father, as millions of children go back to school, we pray that you safely guide them and their daily lives, about their daily lives, and help them adjust to a new sense of normality in their schools. We also pray for the teacher who have to deal with an ever-changing teaching environment. Lord, please bestow your wisdom upon them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Father, our country that is full of this divisive issue, we pray for the unity of Christ. Father, bless our heart and mind so that we may act as one. Please unite us, Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Father, we also pray for our church here in Great Notley and our community. We pray that you help us to love just as you love us, and that we can bring your light into people's lives where it is desperately needed. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We should now observe a moment of silence where we bring our personal prayers to God. We say all this prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
We'll go through the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Reading from Matthew chapter 5, beginning at verse 3. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven, For in the same way, they persecuted the prophets who were before you.
This reading is taken from John chapter 15, verses 9 to 14. As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. If you obey my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have obeyed my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that he lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command.
Thank you. This reading is taken from the book of John, chapter 5, verses 22 to 24. Moreover, the Father judges no one, but has entrusted all judgment to the Son, that all may honour the Son just as they honour the Father. Whoever does not honour the Son does not honour the Father who sent him. I tell you the truth, whoever hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life and will not be condemned. He has crossed over from death to life.
This reading is taken from 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 9 to 10. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people belonging to God, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Once you were not a people, but now you are the people of God. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy.
I feel in every word of power.
thank you everyone for coming today. I hope you've enjoyed the service. Thank you for all those who've participated in the service. Thank you for Bev for coming to play for us today. Refer back to your gold medals. There's been quite a lot of references in the readings today about the race that we're running, how God has refined us. We are gold. So when you go home, hang your medals up somewhere and think this week about how God treasures you. Shall we just pray? I found some very, very old prayers, which we don't hear very often, and I just thought the words were so beautiful. It's lovely to share them. O God, most ancient and most new, food for eternity and power of our being, you are inexhaustible in your love and infinite in your glory. You are the source of all goodness and the fountain of all life. Draw near to us and bless us with the glory of your presence, that we may worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, pierce my soul with your love, that I may long for you with my deepest desire, and thirst for you, the source of all life, wisdom and light. May I seek you and find you, think on you and speak with you, and undertake all things for the honour and glory of your holy name, for your name's sake. Amen. You, O Christ, are the table set before us, the inextinguishable light of the saints, the sun shining in our midst, and you are joy and grace to your people. Shall we stand and join in the grace together? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Thank you.